All right, here we go. First time streaming. Let's see how this goes. I'm gonna be painting some Wookiee warriors. I'm gonna be trying out the Army Painter speed paint for the first time, and yeah, let's see how it goes. It's hardened leather. It's supposed to be like a brown color. There you go. And then I might try mixing the Grave Lord A, and if it's too light, I don't know, we'll see. Too much water. Oh yeah, that's a nice color. Oh, I like that. Alright, let's get some paint on this guy. The zenithal highlighting is working really good at this. Got some nice value transitions. Do-do-do-do. Yeah, that's really nice. Missed a spot. Yeah, I'm not too shabby. Gonna take care of something really quick. My hand. All right, take care of that. Oh, yeah, it's going into the crevices pretty nicely. That's not too bad. Did I miss anything up here? Nope. Need my holder. That's a nice letter. My laptop is not liking streaming. Fans are going nuts. Yeah, this speed paint's pretty sweet. One down, 11 more to go. Oh, he's got some teeth in this one. Now, before I bought this speed paint, I read a lot of reviews and stuff, and some people were saying that it was sometimes difficult to control where the paint flows, but it doesn't seem too bad to me, although they were using like a larger brush. So That might be part of it. I don't know. Also, they were kind of just slopping it on like crazy. I mean, that's kind of what you're supposed to do, but I don't know. I'm just a little... I guess I'm just being a little bit more careful because I'm using it for the first time. Oh, there's my kitty. She's curious about what I'm doing. Hey, you. Not food, can't eat the paint. Silly cat. Yeah, the consistency of the speed paint's pretty nice. To be it. Checking on something. Hold on, kitty. Let's get some more Wookies going. That's because that kind of an angry face. This beeping was basically made for furry type of creatures and stuff. It just goes on so nice. Still might do a dry brush on it though afterwards, just to give it a little bit more highlighting. Also, should probably look into trying a different underpainting color to get different effects. So instead of a black and white, Xenophil, I'll probably do like a dark red and a white or something, or even like a brown, dark brown and then a bright red on top. I don't know, that probably wouldn't work so well. But can always try it and see what happens. Missed a spot here, where's fingers are doing the trigger. Underneath the arm. not going to see it too much, but I guess for the sake of completion. I am sitting in a really bad position. Let's get this fixed. Oh, that's better. Let's just put more in here. Check in something. Yarn. So early when I was trying to start streaming, I was getting some really, really bad frame drops. I think it was caused because my laptop was running at 4K on the display. So I dropped it down to 1080, and that has seemed to get rid of my super high CPU usage. Probably just the OBS window. Trying to push too many pixels. Well, but I've got another computer set up that I'm going to use instead of my laptop soon. But I need to get a USB 3.1 or 3.2 host bus adapter so that I can plug in my webcam. Ooh, what is that? Oh, okay, I guess I'll have to be careful with it drying in the bottom of the well of the painting palette. Interesting. It's a big, huge gloop at the bottom of the painting palette. A bit more in there to get to the crevices, it looks like. I think I've applied it a little bit too thin here. We'll see how that goes. Oh, this one is dried a little bit. Let's take a look and see how that looks. I probably need to apply it a little thicker in some places because it's not really getting into the crevices too much. For that, I might need a bigger brush to hold more in the belly of the brush. Let's see, what do I got? Six, too big. That's a four. Oh, that brush is messed up. Never mind. Let's try a five. See how that goes. Try it on the leg first. Oh, it's definitely going on a lot quicker, that's for sure. A bit centered. Come on, Dan. Into everywhere. Well, thanks, man. Yeah, I had some trouble earlier with the dropping frames. I had to lower my screen resolution because it was trying to push too many pixels. How's the audio sound? Oh, that's good to hear. So I'm using the Tula mic that I got, and I have the noise cancellation enabled on it, and then in OBS I have a limiter set and a, what was the other filter I had set on it? But yeah, it makes a huge difference. Like, you probably don't hear it right now, but my fan's going crazy on my laptop. And with the noise cancellation off, you can definitely hear it. I'm not sure if you can hear it now. Oh, sweet. So yeah, painting some Wookies. I'm using this new paint from Army Painter. It's called Speed Paint, and it goes on really nice and goes all into the crevices and stuff. So it's kind of like a mix between a paint and a wash. And it speeds up the process of getting down your base layers and stuff. So yeah, I'm just getting the fur done first. And then I'm gonna go in and do all the details and then probably do some dry brushing to bring out some more of the highlights. Let's do this guy next. Yeah, like that. Hold on. Bring up my camera controls. Let's zoom in. Net focus. So, yeah, this paint's great. Like, it just like goes right like all into the crevices. Really nice. And it dries pretty matte too. Not like super matte. It's like more of a satin, but that's not that big of a deal. But yeah, like it flows really nice. Let's get back there. Focus down to the normal painting level. Oh, there's Rem. She wants attention. Oh yeah, I was looking at the, I took a quick look at that, the library. I just gotta find some tracks that I like and then get them all downloaded and get them in a playlist. And then I gotta figure out the audio routing in OBS so that basically I wanna be able to, you know, have it go through headphones and then also show up in the stream separately. But because I'm using Linux, I am not sure how the audio routing will work for that, so I'll figure that out. Worst comes worse, I'll just play from the speakers and let the Tula pick it up. But yeah, this is more of a kind of just a test stream, you know, just to see how it feels and see if I actually like doing it and going from there. Kind of gunking together and set it out. I'm sure it's pretty crisp, holy cow. It's pretty kind of absorbent almost. Cast a Wookie next. Look at that flow. I should try doing a gloss varnish first, just to help with the surface tension, see if that makes a big difference or not. Yeah, this speed paint flows really nice. And switching to the bigger brush, I was using a smaller brush earlier, and yeah, bigger brush, more better. All right, the next bowcaster. Yeah, it just seeps right into the crevices. Holy cow, it's nice. Yeah. Yeah, I definitely think a gloss varnish or even a satin varnish first will help with the surface tension. But you know, we'll try it this way first and see how it goes. because the I used ink for the Zenithal highlight, and it's pretty matte. So I wonder if that is interfering with the flow a little bit. Because the ones that are kind of dry, there's not too much of the highlights from the speed paint. But this is the first time I'm using speed paint, so I haven't tried any of the other colors yet. I'm not sure how well they go. Well, let's try the next Wookie. Let's try a different speed paint color. Let's try the Gravelord Gray, just to see, because I've got other Wookies that I can use when I play, and it doesn't hurt to test out the paint. And if I don't like it, I can always just reprime it or strip it. Doesn't matter. Not too worried about getting other details and stuff. I'll just be able to paint over that. It's no big deal. Is it Gravelord Gray? Yeah, it's Gravelord Gray. Looks good. All right, so with this bowcaster, let's see how this paint looks. Right. What I'm using as a reference is some Wookiees I did up a while back from the original Wookiee set. And this is just using inks and normal scale 75 paint. It turned out pretty good, I think. It's not my best job. I've since done better, but I still like them. And then, you know, a little bit of dry brushing there. But let's see how it goes. Oops, fell over. Oh, yeah, that Gravelord Gray is kind of cool. It's going to be a darker Wookiee. Let's see how this looks. Okay, so it's just kind of black. Give it a nice... I wonder if I go over top of it with the brown afterwards, after it's dry. I wonder how that'll look. Yeah, with the Gravelord, probably would have been better for a solid white paint job instead of the Zenithal. The crevices might be a little bit too dark. I don't know. We'll see after it dries. Whoops. or even just a dry brush afterwards with a dark brown and then a lighter brown after that for ideas. All right. Yeah, this bee paint's pretty sweet. Yeah, I think a dry brush afterwards for this one would be pretty good. All right, back to brown or hardened leather. I'm gonna have to order some more of this already. Here we go. Oh, maybe not. It's probably 150 used so far, maybe less. Another bowcaster. Just slop it on there. Yeah, I think slopping it on is the better approach instead of being too careful with it. Just get it on there. Fix up the details later. Actually, I might try the Gravelord Gray for the base of the weapons and then do a dry brush with a silver metallic or something. See how that goes. Give it more of a worn down, well-used look.